UK drivers, are Chinese EVs or Tesla the better choice for 2025? With Chinese brands like BYD outselling Tesla globally and Tesla rolling out major refreshes, it's the EV showdown of the year. In the next few minutes, I'll compare price, technology and the real-world performance to help you make the best decision for your driving needs. So stick around, this comparison could literally shape your next car purchase. And you know what? I've heard from so many of you in the comments, UK drivers wondering whether to go with a Chinese EV or even a Tesla in 2025. And that same curiosity hit me too. You see, last year I dove deep into the EV market for this channel, driving a Tesla Model Y, testing an XPeng G6 and chatting with drivers across the country. The buzz was loud and the comments on my videos were completely split. Chinese EVs are affordable and packed with tech, countered by Tesla's still the gold standard. Do you know what? I had to know the truth, so I dug into the numbers. And this is what I found. BYD sold 1,614 units in January, and that's edging out Tesla's 1,458 according to SMT data. It's a race that's getting tighter every month. So I hit the road, talked to real owners and sifted through all of the stats to get the full picture. So let's break down step by step so you can figure out what's best for you and your next drive. So let's kick this off with price, because let's be honest, we all care about our wallets. And Chinese EVs at the moment are absolutely stealing the spotlight with affordability. Auto Trader reports sub 30k EV options have exploded from just 9 in 2024 to 29 in 2025. And that's driven mainly by brands like BYD and MG. And the BYD Dolphin starts at around 26k in the UK. That's a full 18k less than the Tesla Model 3, which is 44k as a starting price. That's enough savings to buy a decent used car as your second vehicle. And XPeng's G6 SUV, fresh for 2025, comes in at around £30,700. That's still £4,700 less than a Model Y at £35k. That's like getting all of your charging costs covered for the first 2 years. But here's where patience really pays off. You see, Tesla's higher pricing reflects its premium positioning, but their resale value tends to hold much stronger than Chinese models. And we're potentially talking about thousands back in your pocket when you sell or trade. And beyond the sticker shock, consider the total ownership picture. Chinese EVs might save you initially, but Tesla's global support network and proven reliability can offset those higher costs over time. Do you know, it's the classic story of the tortoise versus the hare scenario, immediate savings or long-term value. Your call. Now, design-wise, both sides bring something interesting to the table. Chinese EVs like BYD's Dolphin offer a quirky, compact look, and that's ideal for city driving with its boxy charm and efficient use of space. It's like the IKEA of cars. It's practical and surprisingly spacious inside. XPeng's G6 SUV boasts a sleek silhouette, an enormous panoramic roof, and a modern aesthetic that appeals to families seeking style without the premium price tag. But whoa, Tesla's 2025 refreshes, they're on another level entirely. You see, the Model Y Juniper now features a bold LED light bar inspired by the Cybertruck's rugged vibe, paired with a completely refined interior. And it boasts ambient lighting and upgraded materials for genuinely premium feel. And the Model 3 Highland's aerodynamic tweaks push its range to an impressive 390 miles, blending sleek lines with practical efficiency. And this is enhanced by a revamped dashboard layout that feels like stepping into the future. And Tesla's design evolution feels cohesive and kind of forward-thinking, drawing from a decade of innovation. And Chinese EVs, even though they're improving, they often lean toward function over iconic style, do you know what I mean? More getting the job done than kind of turning heads. And for UK drivers facing our varied weather conditions, Tesla's proven durability is something worth considering alongside those sleek lines. But the thing is, technology is where the competition really heats up, and both sides come armed to the teeth. You see, Chinese EVs pack some seriously impressive gadgets. The XPeng G6 sports a 15-inch rotating screen, Smart OS 5.0 with seamless updates, invisible speakers for immersive sound, and even a mini fridge for long drives. I mean, who doesn't want cold drinks on a road trip? BYD's ambitiously named God's Eye, that's their self-driving technology that's rolled out across the models in 2025, including their £7,500 Seagull, promises advanced navigation capabilities. But you know, here's the catch. It remains largely untested on UK roads with their unique challenges. I'm talking narrow lanes, roundabouts, and drivers who seemingly forgot their indicator exists. Tesla, however, counters with something we're not talking about enough. Full self-driving, which is FSD, now installed in every single car. This isn't just another driver assist. It's revolutionary technology that handles complex urban routes and even dirt roads. And Elon Musk highlighted this after a viral Chinese video claimed their systems were superior. You see, Tesla's autopilot excels in reliability after years of real-world refinement. And it gets over-the-air updates, improving it yearly based on billions of miles of actual driving data. And let's not forget their supercharger network. 73,000 UK chargers in 2025 means you're never more than a short drive from a rapid charge. Try finding that sort of coverage with your Chinese brand emerging infrastructure. But you know what? The thing is, Chinese tech certainly dazzles with novelty and gadgets. But Tesla's proven ecosystem and its mature FSD technology, in my opinion, give it a practical edge that's hard to ignore for day-to-day UK driving conditions. And in the UK market, Chinese brands are making a bold push that deserves our attention. You see, BYD sold 1,614 EVs in January 2025, slightly edging Tesla's 1,458. And Tesla's a staggering 550% jump from last year's figures, according to SMMT data. XPeng's G6 launched with ambitious plans for 2025, targeting 100 dealerships by the end of the year. But meanwhile, MG sold an impressive 81,536 cars in 2024, outpacing Tesla's 50,000. But, and this is an important but, Tesla isn't backing down. Their February sales rose from 20.7%, lifting their market share from 3.75% to 4.6%. And you know what? This shows a remarkable resilience amid intensifying competition. And their established network of showrooms, service centers, and superchargers, in my opinion, gives them a clear advantage. Now, with those 73,000 chargers across the UK in 2025, compare that to the Chinese brand's emerging infrastructure, I think the difference is noticeable. And NIO's innovative approach includes plans for 25 battery swap stations by year end, and I think that's a promising move. But Tesla's supercharger dominance means shorter waits and broader coverage. I don't know, in my opinion, that is critical for UK drivers on long trips on this island. But here's the thing, Chinese dealerships are scaling up rapidly. But the truth is, service wait times can stretch to weeks for some owners. And Tesla's support is renowned for speed and reliability, and that's backed by a robust parts supply chain built over many years. Do you know what? It's a race where Tesla's head start battles against Chinese brands' rapid expansion. But UK consumers stand to benefit, in my opinion, from this competition regardless of who they choose. So, what does this mean for all of us? A UK driver considering an EV purchase in 2025. Chinese EVs like BYD and XPeng offer compelling prices, I'm not gonna lie. Just over 30K for an XPeng G6 versus 35K for Model Y, and that makes them really attractive from a financial perspective. And their technology is gadget packed and improving rapidly. You've got models like the Zeekr X, even earned Euro NCAP's prestigious best-in-class designation. But long-term reliability remains something of a question mark amid occasional quality concerns reported by early adopters. So what about the Tesla refreshes? The Model Y Juniper and the 3 Highland bring a futuristic design language that genuinely turns heads. And this is backed by a brand that's been trusted globally for over a decade. You see, full self-driving in every Tesla sets a new standard for autonomous capabilities. And their technology ecosystem, from autopilot to their extensive supercharger network, has been battle tested across varied terrains and weather conditions. Do you know what? Perhaps the most important for the financially savvy is Tesla's resale value, because I think it holds remarkably strong. Now, this offers significant long-term savings that offset the high initial purchase price. Now, Chinese EVs tempt with immediate savings and novel features, but Tesla's proven performance innovative refreshes and unmatched FSD technology make it the standout choice for navigating UK roads in 2025. That is, for those willing to make the initial investment. So, let me ask you a question. Are you ready to make your EV decision? Here's what I recommend. Test drive a Tesla Model Y or 3, then compare it directly to a Chinese model that fits your budget. Then you can truly see what suits your driving style the best. Also guys, drop a comment below, Chinese EV or Tesla? I'll personally reply with the specific tips based on your situation. Now, if you found this breakdown helpful, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Now, do you want to stay ahead of the EV curve? That's really cool, because every Thursday I send out a comprehensive analysis of the week's biggest developments in the electric vehicle space. From breaking technical innovations to market movements that matter, the Electric Oracle Weekly delivers the insights you need straight into your inbox. And guys, it's free. It's focused and it's made for people who want to understand where this industry is really heading. You'll actually find the sign up link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. My name's Des from the Electric Oracle, and I'll see you in the next video.